on September 16, 2023, a large landslide occurred at a steep cliffside in remote eastern Greenland. As an estimated 4.6 million cubic meters of rock slid into a fjord that connects to the ocean, large rocks enter the water after falling more than 1,500 feet, displacing large amounts of water. This displacement of water quickly generated a towering wave. A mega tsunami had been generated with an initial wave height of 100 meters or 328 feet. Moving outwards from its source, the wave height rapidly decreased, but when it hit a settlement on Ella Island, 56 kilometers to the east-northeast, the tsunami waves ran up the coastline to areas up to 7 meters or 23 feet above sea level. After the water had receded, the damage was found to be significant. What could amount to millions of dollars in damage likely occurred, even completely pulling some structures several hundred feet into the ocean. Yet, partially due to sheer luck, there was no injuries or fatalities. Simply put, if this disaster had occurred 2 months earlier, there may have very well been fatalities. But instead, the relevant settlement was completely abandoned for the season when the tsunami struck, as people generally only live in this settlement during the summer. A researcher I spoke with noted that the run-up, aka the height above the typical waterline the tsunami reached, was observed at locations up to a distance of 100 kilometers away from the landslide site. Although the settlement on this island will almost certainly remain abandoned for the winter, in my opinion, I would caution people against returning to this location until we know for sure that the immediate landslide hazard has ceased, else more smaller-scale landslide-generated tsunamis could unexpectedly occur. I say this for two reasons. 1. The landslide involving a 309-meter-wide and 240-meter-long section of hillside not only could have potentially destabilized directly adjacent rock, but the landslide which occurred could be incomplete, with a chance of additional sections collapsing during subsequent weeks and precipitation events. The second reason is that if we look at the adjacent area, which is largely a 50-degree slope, we can find at least two other depressions in the rock that also appear to be landslide scarps within a 2,500-meter radius. This suggests that the landslide which occurred might not be an isolated event, and instead may only be the first tsunami witnessed since Ella Island was first settled in 1906. Of course, the hillside has not been studied in detail, so what I just stated is pure speculation and not backed by hard science, meaning it could be incorrect. So, why did this tsunami occur? Since 1850, at least 8 large-scale tsunamis have been created by partial edifice collapse of a weakened mountainside or cliff in colder parts of the world in close proximity to glaciers. This has occurred multiple times in parts of Alaska and Greenland during this time span, with the largest landslide-generated tsunami resulting in an initially 524 meters or 1,720-foot-high wave. However, while the 1958 Alaska landslide and tsunami was in part caused by a large magnitude earthquake, the cause of the 3 most recent landslide-triggered tsunamis in colder climates were likely all caused by the same slow-moving process, glacial retreat. Oftentimes, on the edges of fjords and glacial valleys glaciers created are a series of steep slopes which would normally be incredibly prone to collapsing if not for the fact that a glacier for thousands of years has been largely preventing them from collapsing, having originally carved these steep slopes in the first place. However, once the glacier retreats beyond a steep slope prone to collapse, a slow-moving landslide might begin due to the absence of glacial ice which was previously holding the slope in place. This eventually culminates in a massive chunk of material falling off as a single block before sliding into a body of water and generating a tsunami through displacement. After the tsunami is generated, the water eventually calms, leaving behind a scar in the hillside, a new tree line of trees exist in the region marking the maximum tsunami run-up height, and, on occasion, even creates hummocky terrain. Since glaciers are largely retreating all across Greenland, similar landslides are likely to occur in the future, with this representing the second such event since 2016. Although this could simply be a symptom of a small sample size, the 5-dated most recent large fjord-related landslide-generated tsunamis have all occurred during either warm months or the fall season, specifically between June and October. The odds of this being a mere coincidence is only 1.26%. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.